Welcome back into the Solid Blue SEC Tournament Special Report presented by the Kentucky Lottery. Live here from Nashville, Bridgestone Arena, Alex Risen joined alongside by Aaron Allison. 21-10, 12-6 in Southeastern Conference play. That's the Kentucky Wildcats season on paper, Aaron. But what do you not get?
First, we had Ryan Harrow's mystery illness where he missed about a month. And Willie Cauley-Stein missed about a month with a knee injury. And then New Orleans Noel's devastating and emotionally tough and physically tough to watch injury at Florida.
Yeah, that torn ACL really changed the season for the Cats. The drubbing they took by Tennessee by 30 points at Knoxville. Coach Cal's worst loss ever. And obviously the worst loss in program history down at Rocky Top. You also missed the pageantry that is Big Blue Madness. You certainly can't get that on paper. No. It's so tough to even, you know, put into words.
When still here. Fans are still showing up right now walking in.
Yeah, Solid Blue fans probably outweigh everybody else right now. And that's kind of the interesting part that is, you know, Solid Blue fans and the Solid Blue faithful. But where did Kentucky start this season?
At the top, they hit the bottom. Now where are they? The bubble?
Maybe the bubble. If they are, Aaron, second chance on life in postseason play.
It's Friday night. Kentucky with a 72-69 victory. They hold on for the win.
Tonight was a learning process.
As the Duke Blue Devils, in their first meeting with Kentucky in 11 years, hand the young Wildcats a loss, 75-68.
Two teams just battling each other. I mean, Notre Dame wins. That's not what this was. This was Notre Dame throwing around Kentucky.
There was crucial games that we needed to win just to get stuff kind of steamrolling out. We're back at square one trying to figure out how we're going to play and who's ready to play, and it's just a mess.
This team, you know, you got to hate to lose.
We got to find out what's the Rupp Arena record for a visiting player.
I was trying to get it on my own.
Is it too soon to worry about you guys winning enough games to make the NCAA tournament?
Yeah, we'll be good.
It's going to be another month before this team comes together. I just hope we're winning enough games as we learn to do this. I've coached teams that have absolutely whomped on people, and this ain't one of them. I can't imagine this team being up 20 on anybody.
Noel over the top of Sullivan.
Huge opportunity for Kentucky tonight. Gromez rebound by Alex Poitras. And this young Kentucky team is growing up in the second half in Oxford.
We're not that skilled. You want to say this guy's this and that? We're not that skilled.
Oh, Noel hit his left knee on the basket brace.
Physically sick right now for him. And if it were a walk-on, I'd be sick for that young man, too. What I'm hoping is it's not the extreme. I'm hoping it's some sort of twist.
Looking at a young guy that's projected by all the scouting reports, basically the number one player in the NBA draft. Let's hope and pray it's not as bad as it looks.
It doesn't look good right now, but I've had seasons where it's looked awful and went off, and I've had seasons where it looked real good and went the wrong way. It's what it is. If they weren't embarrassed by this, to come to me and say, tell us whatever you want, we're going to listen to you, then they shouldn't be in Kentucky, you know that. For them to come back, it shows what they're about. I mean, they know. I mean, this team, I keep telling them, this could be the greatest story in the college basketball season if they want it to be.
We're starting over, basically.
Started from the bottom, now we're here.
For a good 2 days, I just felt depressed. Like, I didn't want to come out of my room.
We're missing a key person. And, you know, this is just another you know, roadblock that was in our way.
I put a sheet over my window. It was just dark.
Create a swagger. Right now, we're not quite there.
Now I can just watch Netflix all day and eat when I needed to.
They're starting to be empowered. And if they're empowered, they're going to be better. And that's what you're starting to see.
They deserve to win. They played better. They were better coached. They deserve to win the game. I wake up every day, don't know how the team will play.
At our best, we are an NCAA tournament team. And we're not at our best. We're not very good.